Good afternoon and welcome to a sunny Bob Hanna Stadium on the campus of the University of Delaware, as it's a nice day for some CAA baseball between the Delaware Fighting Blue Hens and the UNCW Seahawks. So we look at our weather. It's a beautiful 78 degrees, humidity 34%, winds 15 miles per hour out of the southwest. Michael Baum joined alongside Danny Laddie. And Danny, the last time these two teams met, Delaware raised the CAA championship trophy in UNCW's stadium. You have to think that they are going to be thinking about that, both teams really, during this game.
Yeah, definitely. UNCW definitely wants to come out here and get revenge for losing the CAA championship in their own stadium. Delaware had to beat them twice, too, in that CAA tournament. Has played UNCW well the last three times that they have met them, so it'd be a good game here today. Delaware riding some momentum coming into today, but UNCW looking for the revenge.
And in a short couple minutes, we'll bring it to you that we will have the CAA championship banner unveiled in right field. A lot of new graphics on that right field wall, which we will show you when it comes. But not only did, as we're going to look at the starting pitchers brought to you by the Delaware Lottery. For the Blue Hens, it will be Kyle Hinton. And then for the Seahawks, it will be Alex Royalty. Both juniors, both 3-3 on the year, both making their ninth start of the year. Both two good pitchers for their respective teams.
Yeah, you said definitely good pitchers. Both pitch about the same amount of innings. Kyle Hinton with the lower ERA, as we see. It's a 2.51 ERA. And he's keeping the hitter's average pretty low. Walks not have been an issue too far, with four walks and only those eight starts, so only about a walk every other game, which, you know, I got to keep people off the bases, and reducing the walks is definitely key for Kyle Hinton.
And Kyle Hinton was the winning pitcher in the CAA championship game that Delaware beat UNCW. He came in, pitched seven innings in relief, ended up getting the win, and he had a great stat line that game. Seven innings, four hits, one earned runs, no walks, three strikeouts. Coleman Villa started the game, only pitched two innings, giving up two earned runs, but that was a game that Delaware pitchers, one of their biggest problems last year was the walks. Last, during the championship game, no walks in that whole game.
Yeah, no walks at all. Like I just said before, you keep people off the bases, it's a lot harder for them to score. Getting on base by walking is the easiest way to get on base. So no walks, and like you said, it's a championship game. There's a short lease for pitchers, and starter only went two innings. Kyle Hinton had to pick up the slack and go finish the game, and he finished it strong, and good finish and a great CAA championship.
And this is a critical early CAA matchup between these two teams, UNCW just ahead of Delaware in the standings. But come end of the season, the standings can get very tight, and games early on in CAA play could be a huge factor in deciding the CAA.
Yeah, I mean, we see it right now. Delaware only 3-3 record, or just 500 in the CAA, but the teams ahead of them, Northeastern and Charleston, they're not going to slow down towards the end of the season when CAA play comes along and it's in full swing. So Delaware's going to need to pick up the games, especially at home in the front of the home crowd, take advantage of the home field advantage, and play tough CAA baseball.
And the Blue Hens coming off a good win at Lehigh in the Libertyville Classic semis against Lehigh. 15-7 was the final score, and that was a game where the Blue Hens offense just struck gold, it seemed like.
Yeah, they started off the game hot, and they stayed hot the whole game. Kevin Mahala got on base every single time, between walks, hitting the ball, scoring runs. I mean, we're going to look for him to lead it off for the Blue Hens again today and continue his streak of just getting on base.
You mentioned Kevin Mahalan getting on base every time. It's crucial that you get your leadoff hitter on base, especially when he can draw three walks and get three hits in addition to that.
Yeah, his on-base percentage is .421. I mean, as a leadoff man, on-base percentage anywhere near 400 is good, but .421 is just out of the park. But it's good for Delaware to get that leadoff man on. And then with his speed, too, he's always a threat to go, so it'll be interesting to see how he plays here today.
And what's also good about last game is Haas came in and started the game 5 innings strong, only giving up the 1 earned run. That he gave up 3 hits, 1 walk, no strikeouts. But the bullpen, mostly available, only Haas, we think, is the only one not available for this game. And for a huge weekend against UNCW, that's huge coming into it. You have almost all your pitchers available.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how Delaware uses their pitchers today, because like you said, it is a big weekend of CAA baseball, and with everybody available, you gotta, obviously you want to win these CAA games, but you also need to be smart and save pitchers for the whole weekend and with midweek games coming up next week.
And especially looking ahead, the Blue Hens have a lot of games coming up. Even with this series, they have 2 midweek games coming up, so it'll be interesting to see how Coach Sherman handles his pitching staff in this series.
And one midweek game is the Liberty Bowl Classic Championship, so that'll be interesting to see.
And now we will join public address announcer Andrew Stern for the unveiling of the CAA Championship Band. Association Championship Team of the University of Delaware.
And Delaware fans, once again, we're proud to celebrate the 2017 Colonial Athletic Association Championship Team for the University of Delaware Baseball Program. Last season's squad, captained by Ron Marinaccio and Nick Spadafino, were dominant in the CAA tournament, winning games on 4 straight games and outscoring their opponents 38-14. Please direct your attention to the right field scoreboard area where the 2017 banner will be unveiled. Join Director of Athletic and Recreation Services, Chrissy Raywalk, Head Coach, Jim Sherman, and 2018 Captains, Diaz Nardo and Calvin Scott. And fans, help us celebrate and congratulate once again your 2017 CAA Baseball Champions.
And there you have it, one of the new graphics that's out there in right field. They were all just put in recently, but now the conference champions 2017 banner unveiled. As kind of for UNCW, that's even a more reason to have motivation for this game, Danny.
Yeah, especially UNCW was warming up down the right field line right in front of that banner unveiling, so definitely a kind of a slap in the face, if you would say, but beautiful, not really a banner, just a sticker on the wall, but either way, it looks very nice out there on the blue wall.
as now we'll look at the starting lineups for the Blue Hens. The batting lineup will be Kevin Mahalan, Eric Bowerin, Kyle Baker, Nick Penn, Calvin Scott, Chance DeFebo, Jordan Hutchins, Zach Miller, Vinny Vaccone, and then Kyle Hinton on the mound for the Hens. And we kind of already talked about Kevin Mahalan, but who else in this game for the Blue Hens needs to stick up and be a crucial player in this batting lineup?
It's going to be the top of the order. Kyle Baker leading the team with a 326 average. I mean, Kevin Mahalan is going to get on base. We know that in this game, so we're going to need Kyle Baker, Calvin Scott with 14 RBIs on the year just to drive in those guys that are getting on in the top of the lineup.
And the starting lineup for UNCW is as follows. Shortstop Greg Jones, right fielder Noah Lyles, catcher Ryan Jeffers, first baseman Mason Byrne, left fielder Zach Canada, designated hitter Blake Deathridge, third baseman Cole Weiss, second baseman Jackson Meadows, center fielder Noah Bridges, and on the mound, as we already mentioned, Alex Royalty. And this is a UNCW lineup that has a lot of power compared to the Delaware lineup that not as much power, not as much a home run threat.
Yeah, you look at the number 3 and 4 hitter, Ryan Jeffers and Mason Byrne, 342 and 372 batting average respectively, and the two of them have 9 home runs and 8 home runs each. Like you said, a lot more power in this lineup. It's going to be interesting. Kyle Hinton's going to have to keep the ball low to keep the ball in the park against these sluggers.
We're going to step aside for a short break. When we return, keys to the game and first pitch. You're watching Delaware Baseball and Hens All Access on BlueHens.com.
Calling all creators.
Those with the need
to make something new.
Who are obsessed with progress.
Creativity is everything in today's game.
It's about making a statement.
I think what we're all trying to do is leave a mark so the game will never be the same.
The game will never
be the same.
We're all creators.
Related by a mindset.
That's our job, to continue to try to enlighten while we inspire.
I've been taking the example of it, but now I have to create for myself.
It's not about borders.
Gender.
A race.
I ain't trying to stay in my lane. I'm trying to strike while the iron hot.
It's all intertwined. Fashion inspires music.
Music, art, design, and sport together.
Come on, Hopkins. You know you listening to Pusha T before you hit the field. And Aaron Rodgers, maybe you should.
Join us.
Pull up a chair.
Let's change sport.
Change lives.
Let's create.
Here's your chance to win big and adventure bigger on the Powerball Power Cruise on board Royal Caribbean's Majesty of the Seas. Play Powerball today and enter to be one of the lucky winners of an exclusive adventure of a lifetime. You'll enjoy a private concert featuring Kenny Loggins and even get a shot at $250,000 in cash prizes on board. The only way to get on board is to play Powerball and enter to win big.
6 Delaware Lottery players will win. Visit eelottery.com for details. Want to play?
Together again, under one roof, for one incredible tour. Newsboys United, all the hits.
This is Entertaining Angels.
And one amazing concert coming soon to a city near you. Newsboys United.
My God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's
Rome.
Let's go.
What kind of SUV is that?
It's a brand new Buick Enclave.
That really makes it easy to unload all those little maniacs.
Sure does.
Hey, honey, we should get one of those and have like a ton more kids.
Yeah, I love that. More kids.
Yeah.
Introducing the all-new Buick Enclave. Tomorrow's SUV for today's family. Current lessees, switch to Buick and get this low-mileage lease on this 2018 Buick Enclave for around $369 per month.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium as the Blue Hens face the UNCW Seahawks. Warming up for the Blue Hens on the mound, Kyle Hinton, the junior, trying to win his fourth game of the year as the Blue Hens will try to start off this series on a winning note and kind of put the Seahawks in the back seat a little bit.
Yeah, nice to start CAA play at home with a win and with nice weather here in Newark and put UNCW behind to start this weekend series.
As now, let's take a look at the keys to the game powered by Chevy. Danny, what are your keys to today's game?
Well, for Kyle Hinton, he's got to keep the ball low and keep the ball in the park. Like I said, those three and four hitters combined for 17 home runs on the year, and they have pop in their bat today for UNCW. And then for the Blue Hens offense, just get runners on base and use the speed and move runners on. Like, we're not going to see the power from the Blue Hens. They're just going to play small ball, one base at a time, and take advantage of the UNCW defense.
Blue Hens coming in 3-3 in the CAA. Overall at home, 9-5, 15-14 overall. As a whole, the Seahawks coming in 20-12, 4-2 in the CAA. As now our first batter will come to the plate, now batting Greg Jones, the shortstop. First pitch inside, brushing him off a little bit, trying to establish the plate a little
bit.
That's
his plate inside corner. Making sure he's awake to start the day, too. Even though it is 3 o'clock.
The 1-0, once again missing, 2-0 count quickly.
Back-to-back pitches going inside against Jones here.
As we see Jordan Hutchins, third baseman for the Blue Hens, up a little bit, playing just in case for a bunt. 2-0, a swing and a miss. He was trying to give the Seahawks a 1-0 lead right there.
He was. Had two home runs on the year to start off as a leadoff hitter, so you never know. But the first two pitches were both inside. He decided to change it up a little bit, go away.
The delivery will miss once again. He can't believe it. Hinton showing that he thought that was a strike.
We're not umpires.
So it's... As now Hinton takes a long look at the plate before delivering. He'll get caught a strike.
Finally hit that inside corner for a strike.
So it's a full count to the first batter that Kyle Hinton will face. As now time is caught at the plate by Greg Jones. Hinton was taking a little too long for his liking. Hinton quickly for the full count delivery. And it will miss. So a leadoff walk for the Seahawks. So now a runner on first, and that could be a huge advantage for the Seahawks. Greg Jones only your 7 stolen bases in 11 attempts.
We talked about that in pregame about got to keep runners off base from walks, and not a good sign when the first batter of the game gets walked.
So now Noah Lyles, the right fielder, will come to the plate for the Seahawks. As he shows bunt, a lot of movement there for Delaware all around.
Looks like UNCW is trying to get Jones into scoring position for their sluggers coming up.
Lyles on the year, 273 batter in the second hole today. The delivery shows bunt once again. It's popped up behind the plate. Can't get it, so it'll be a foul ball at least. They do get the one strike.
That's a good pitch by Hinton, though. When you see a batter's bunting, and obviously we know he's bunting, pitch the ball high, and just like the result got Hinton exactly what he wanted.
And now you got to think whether Lyles will try to attempt another bunt because he's already popped one up. It'll be interesting to see what UNCW will go with here. Hutchins still moved in, playing bunt defense at third base. And Hinton will check over to the runner at first, back in there safely. So it's a 1-1 count right now to Noah Lyles, the right fielder for the Seahawks. Hinton's delivery with the runner going. It's hit to right field. Baker moving back on in right center field will grab it and will force Jones to go back to first base.
I guess they didn't trust him to bunt again. Got a good medal on that, though. But
as now the catcher, Ryan Jeffers, will come to the plate, batting 342 on the year. 9 home runs, 32 RBIs. This is the guy that Seahawks always wanted to play if they could have him.
And look at this, 15 doubles, too. More than half of his hits are extra base hits.
So Jeffers with the runner going again. The throw to second will not be in time. The one hopper does not make it there in time. And so now Jones at second base.
Looked like the exchange from glove to hand for Miller wasn't too clean. Looked like he bobbled it a little bit before he fired that to second.
Kind of a double whammy. The pitch was a ball, and you don't get the runner out at second. So it's a 1-0 count now to Jeffers with a runner in scoring position.
So he's wearing batting gloves, and he has batting gloves in his back pocket. What do you think that one's for?
Different gloves to catch with.
I guess so.
As it's a called strike, and now Miller will go talk to Hinton at the mound. Now they're going to bring in Vaccone.
Looked like they had a cross-up in the signs. Didn't know which one they were going with.
And this is important in the beginning stages of the game when you have a runner, especially at second base, making sure you have those signs down correctly so that your catcher knows what's coming his way.
As a catcher, you would like to know what's coming at you.
So Bowerin will hold the runner on at second base a little bit, just making sure Jones does not get a huge lead. The 1-1 will be down low. So it'll be a 2-1 count now to Ryan Jeffers, someone you don't want to fall behind in the count. A little bit larger lead over there for Jones at second base than the previous pitch. Hinton will come set. The 2-1 delivery just missing outside. Be a 3-1 count now.
Trying to go with the back door. Looks like a slider a little bit. Now 3-1 count, not what you want against Jeffers. He's going to be sitting dead fastball now. You got to come to him too.
So it looks like the outfield playing deep to Jeffers, respectively, with the 9 home runs leading UNCW. And it's hit, grabbed by Bowerin, and doubled them off at second base. And that's how the inning will.
Just the way they drew it up.
0 runs, 0 hits on no errors. We'll go to the bottom of the first, tied at 0. Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium. The last half inning ended on a leaping grab by Bowerin to double them off at second base. We thought that was going over his head, both of us, but he had the hops over there at second base.
Yeah, we said too, 3-1 count, he had to come to Jeffers, and Jeffers got a good shot on it, but didn't get high enough as Bowerin made a great play, leaping to snag that.
So now Alex Royalty will come to the mound for the Seahawks, 3-3 on the year. For the Seahawks, and now batting Kevin Mahalan, batting 305 on the year. And especially in the leadoff spot, batting 378 for the Blue Hens on the year. Mahalan will try to get something going for his Blue Hens offense last game. 3 hits and 3 walks. The first delivery to him be a called strike. And this Blue Hens offense is very patient. We'll wait for their pitch to drive and hit it where they want it to.
Yeah, 4 out of the first 5 batters all double-digit walks on the season, too.
Next pitch just missing. It'll be a 1-1 count now to Kevin Mahalan. The Blue Hens center fielder, 15 walks so far on the year. Next pitch, just hitting the outside corner. Nice off-speed.
Good breaking ball right there. 2 strikes now. Just saw the breaking ball with 1 strike. It's interesting to see what he's going to do with 2. They're shading him to right field in the outfield, too.
And the infield's moved over a little bit to the left. The next pitch, just missing. So even up the count at 2-2 to Kevin Mahalan.
Back-to-back breaking balls. Michael Heater up in the zone.
Royalty's delivery will be hit by Mahalan. Bridges will make the catch in center field. 1 away for the Hens.
Now batting for the Blue Hens.
As now coming to the plate, second baseman Eric Boer, and the guy that just made the great play in the field.
See if he can follow it up now with a base hit.
But that last at bat by Mahalan put some good metal on that ball, especially with 2 strikes already on it. So now Bowerin will come to the plate, batting 286 on the year.
Outfield shading him to the right field as well.
First pitch to Bowerin. Be a called strike in the lower half of the zone. 0-1 now. Royalty's working very quickly for a pitcher as opposed to him who likes to take his time out there. Royalty's delivery will just miss, even as up the count at 1-1.
Looks like he's got a changeup in his arsenal, pitch arsenal as well. See fastball curve change.
The 1-1 delivery will just miss outside, trying to paint the outside corner. It misses. It's now 2-1, and now Bowerin in the driver's seat a little bit with more of a hitter's count. However, we saw last at bat that he's willing to throw a breaking ball with only 1 strike. And the next pitch is a fastball that he swings through to even up the count of 2. So now Bowerin will take his time getting back into the box with the 2-2 count. You can really expect anything from Royalty here. 2-2 delivery. An off-speeder just missing. It was a close pitch to take with 2 strikes. Bowerin got the call, though, so now it's a full count.
He's got his curve working today. It was a nice tight curve on it, too. It's good to establish the curve early. Find the release point, and he found it today.
The full count delivery will be a called strike 3.
Right on cue, the curve.
So Royalty gets his first strikeout of the day. Now batting right fielder Kyle Baker. It seems like Royalty is very comfortable throwing that off-speed pitch at any part of the count.
Well, I mean, we've seen it up here. It looks like he must see it on the mound until he's found the release point here today with the curve. And when you have that release point going, you got to live on that.
So the first pitch to Baker, he'll swing through it. for strike one. It's an 0-1 count now to Baker. And interestingly enough, Kyle Baker batting very well this year, 326 with two outs, batting 457 on the year. So look to get that average up even a little bit more. Takes ball one, so evens up the count at 1-1. So Royalty will deliver, and Baker swings through it, makes the count 1-2. Royalty has not been scared of any of these batters. He's been going right at them.
Yep, he's coming right at him. He's going to finish. He's going to come right at him again, finish the inning. That's what he wants to do. Going outside.
The delivery. Baker hits it to second base. Meadows, unable to handle it, took his eyes off of it when he was trying to transfer it. And now the Blue Hens will have a runner at first base.
UNCW are not used to playing on turf, I guess. So that ball just took off of the turf.
As they're officially going to roll that a hit because of how the turf plays. It's a different play. So now coming to the plate, Nick Patton. He has been playing great this year, as expected. He currently has a 7-game hit streak and has reached base 20 games consecutively. First pitch to him will hit the outside corner for a called strike one. So it'll be an 0-1 count to Patton. Royalty looks over at first base and delivers. Misses up high, evens up the count at 1-1.
Playing him to pull the ball, too. Look at where the second baseman is, right behind the bag.
Patton has a huge gap on the right side of the infield, especially with the runner being held on at first base.
Good block.
Good block by the catcher as the ball was in the turf.
I was wondering why you didn't say dirt, and I realized.
The all-turf field here at Bob Hanna Stadium. It's a 2-1 count now to Nick Patton, the Blue Hens' cleanup hitter today, batting 240 on the year. Royalty looks over at first, but will deliver home. Patton hits it to third base. That's Weiss. He bobbles it a little bit. Patton trying to beat it out, but they just get him out. No runs on one hit, no errors. We'll head to the top of the second, tied at zero.
Bottom of the first. No runs. There was a hit, no errors, and they lead. Amen.
Calling all creators.
Those with the need
to make something new.
Who are obsessed with progress.
Creativity is everything in today's game.
It's about making a statement.
I think what we're all trying to do is leave a mark so the game will never be the same.
The game will never
be the same.
We're all creators.
Related by a mindset.
That's our job, to continue to try to enlighten while we inspire.
I've been taking the example of it, but now I have to create for myself.
It's not about borders,
gender,
or race.
I ain't trying to stay in my lane. I'm trying to strike while the iron hot.
It's all intertwined. Fashion inspires music.
Music, art, design, and sport together.
Come on, Hopkins. You know you listening to Pusha T before you hit the field. And Aaron Rodgers, maybe you should.
Join us.
Pull up a chair.
Let's change sport.
Let's change lives.
Let's create.
Hi, guys. So this is the all-new Chevy Equinox.
It's gorgeous.
It offers heated and ventilated front seats, heated rear seats, a panoramic sunroof, built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, Apple CarPlay compatibility, surround vision, safety alert seat, and teen driver technology.
All of that is in this one car.
Yeah, and to get all these features, you would have to buy all five of those crossovers.
Whoa.
Oh, and the Lexus NX.
That's insane.
Yep, all six of these, and you still wouldn't get everything that's in this Equinox.
Chevy's raising the bar.
Six cars in one.
I like that.
Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium. Top of the second. Mason Byrne at the plate, the first baseman. The first pitch was a ball. Second pitch, also a ball. 2-0 count now quickly to Byrne. Also very much a power hitter for this UNCW lineup. Hinton will deliver, and it's hit to center field. Mahalan coming in, losing his hat, but able to make the play.
Played him for power. They were a deep back. He had to run a long ways to get just to get that ball.
He's now coming to the plate, Zach Canada, the left fielder, senior, batting 267 on the year for the Seahawks. Also not that bad of power, 5 home runs on the year, slugging 457. Blue Hens outfield still playing deep, only a couple steps away from the warning track. In left field is DeFebo. It's hit over to third base. Hutchins gloves it, throws it over to Patton, and quickly two away for the Hens.
A much better start to the second inning than the first inning when you lead off walk.
Now batting for the Seahawks.
For hitting.
Hitter number 11, Blake Kepler.
This inning right now so far is helping his pitch count after he had a pretty high one in the first.
15 pitches in the first inning, only 4 so far in this inning. And working fast once again, it'll be a ball, 1-0 count. The next delivery from Hinn, get fouled off behind the press box and home plate. So it'll be a 1-1 count. At the plate is Blake Deathridge, the designated hitter. Only his 6th at-bat of the year. So the 400 batting average.
A little skewed.
Next pitch hits the outside corner, and now Hinn in the driver's seat with the 1-2 count.
1-2 count, he's got a couple pitches to play with here if he wants to play around, if he just wants to go get him.
Hens in comes set, the delivery, trying for that same pitch on the outside
he
corner.
He tried to go get him.
Almost got just him, was. But just outside, evens up the count 2-2. But he still has plenty of room to work with.
Miller did a good job trying to frame that too, trying to get the call, but the ump wasn't falling for it today.
The delivery. Brett tried brushing him off, go a little outside, then a little inside action, and now it's a full count, however.
He tried going with the breaking ball, just missed his spot, didn't get his release point where he wanted to. Now he's got to make a pitch here, full count.
The full count delivery will be hit to short. Vacone just able to knock it down. It'll be ruled a base hit. So now the Seahawks will have a runner on at first base.
Did a good job of keeping that in the infield. Just couldn't field it cleanly with his bare hand, and once he got up.
Now coming to the plate will be Cole Weiss, the third baseman, batting 230 on the year. Hinton now has to look the runner, make sure the runner doesn't get too big of a lead, and then delivers. Ball down low. It's a 1-0 count. Hinton's been working behind a lot of the batters so far in this game.
Yeah, I think pretty much almost every batter except for Deathridge, who's on first now, he's been behind almost every time. He's got to get first pitch strikes here. He's got to work on that.
The 1-0 delivery from Hinton will be hit and just past the outstretched glove of Vacone, and they're going to round Deathridge all the way to home, and he will score. So a double, RBI double for Cole Weiss.
That's just DeFebo in left field just did not read that ball correctly. He started running to go back up third base thinking Vacone was going to get that, but he was already behind now getting to the ball. And then when he slipped too, that runner scored easily all the way from first.
So the Seahawks had nothing going with 2 outs, and now they are able to manufacture a run with 2 away. And now Jackson Meadows will come to the plate, the second baseman for the Seahawks.
Hitting was 1 strike away from getting out of this inning, and now runner on second and a run later.
Yeah, called strike 1. So Hinn now working in his favor, 0-1, starting off this batter. Hinton, when a runner's on base, takes a lot longer, works much slower, as now time's called at the plate. But he's a much, much different pace when a runner's on base and not on base. A a decent size lead over there at second base for Weiss. The delivery, miss outside, evens up the count at 1-1. There's a nice gap on the right side of the infield for Meadows if he chooses to use it, with Bower and holding on Weiss a little bit over there at second base. And then he gets a swing and a miss for strike two. It's now a 1-2 count to Jackson Meadows.
Meadows tried killing that ball. He had his back leg swinging out and everything.
On the year, only 3 RBIs for Meadows. Blue Hens trying to get out of this with only the 1 run scored. Hinton delivers the 1-2, just missing. Miller trying to frame that ball. So 2-2 count now to Meadows. So he'll try to extend the Seahawks inning. Hinton trying to end it, and he can do so with 1 pitch. The delivery, as it'll be popped into right field. Baker looking for it in the sun, will make the play, but already 1 run scored, 2 hits, no error. Seahawks take the lead 1-0, bottom of the second coming up.
And to the bottom of the second here at Bob Hanna Stadium.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Together again. Under one roof for one incredible tour. Newsboys United, all the hits.
This is Entertaining Angels.
And one amazing concert coming soon to a city near you. Newsboys United.
My God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's
lead in the top of the second. We head to the bottom of the second. Seahawks leading the game 1-0. Calvin Scott will come to the plate, the designated hitter today for the Blue Hens. First pitch from Royalty, missing up high for ball one. So Royalty comes from the windup, the delivery. Scott hits it a little hit up the middle, but it'll be glove this time by Meadows, able to get the transfer over this time to make the out at first.
Royalty jammed him there a little bit. A little soft, weak hit to second.
As now coming to the plate for the Hens, Chance DeFebo trying to, maybe with this at bat, make up for the poor play in the outfield that led to the 1 run for the Seahawks. DeFebo swings through the first one, strike one. DeFebo in the year only batting 189. This is only his 38th at bat of the season. Now swing through another one quickly, 0-2. And we've seen what Royalty can do with a 1-2 count. You can only imagine what we can see from him right here on this 0-2 count. The 0-2 delivering, he'll go hard and away, just missing 1-2 count now.
Smart going with the fastball there. We've seen DeFebo's been late on the first two. So Royalty decided to stay with it. Just missed his spot outside. Try getting in the chase.
The 1-2 delivery. And they're going to say DeFebo just checked up at. They appealed to the first base umpire. He just checked up. So now it's 2-2 count. So the 2-2 delivery from Royalty is a chopper up the middle. Meadows gloves it, throws it over to first, and now two away for the Hens.
Back-to-back balls to the second baseman, Meadows. Looks like he already adjusted to the play on turf.
So now coming to play, Jordan Hutchins, the third baseman today. In this all-righty lineup for the Hens, no left-handed batters for the Blue Hens today. First pitch from Royalty, just missing outside.
He wanted that pitch. He wanted to get that call. Shook his head a little bit.
The 1-0 delivery from Royalty, missing once again, 2-0. Royalty not really happy with some of these calls so far early on in this game. So now Hutchins in the driver's seat with the 2-0. And that will be called strike. Now a 2-1 count.
Now Hutchins isn't happy with the call.
Hutchins thought maybe a little low. The 2-1 delivery now will be hit. Past the outstretched glove of Byrne. It will be a single. He's going to try to advance to a double. The slide, and he's in there safely. A heads-up play by Hutchins. Saw that Lyles was taking a while to get to the ball, advance all the way to second.
Yeah, he started hustling right out of the box. And good hustle play to get this all the way to second. Runner in scoring position now, two men away. Almost slid past the base there with his turf slide. A lot quicker, too.
And even if Byrne was able to stop that at first base, Hutchins was going to give him a hard time trying to get him out even at first base because of that speed.
Yeah, would have had to get up quick and get to first.
But now Zach Miller will come up with two outs and a runner in scoring position at second base. Miller catching today, batting 164 on the year. First delivery to him. An off-speed pitch outside and low, 1-0 now to Miller. Now Royalty taking a little longer than even before to look at the signs. Come set, delivers. Tried going hard and away, missing the outside corner just a little bit. Now it's a 2-0 count to Zach Miller. The Royalty working behind on Miller. 2-0 delivery will be fouled off behind home plate. Now 2-1 count to Miller. Miller on the year, only his 56th at-bat of the year. 7 RBIs, 5 walks. Struck out already 13 times this season. Only 1 extra base hit in 1 double. Royalty comes set. The delivery will be a chopper to third base. Weiss will throw it over to first base to Byrne, and that's how the inning will end. No runs on one hit, no errors. We'll go to the top of the third. Seahawks leading this game 1-0. No errors, and one man left. Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium. Top of the third. Seahawks leading this game 1-0. First pitch to Bridges outside for a ball. So it'll be 9, and then the top of the order, Jones and Lyles to follow Bridges.
Hinton's having trouble hitting his spots. Miller wanted that ball in, and it ended up away. There it is again.
Another pitch that missed badly outside, you can say. 2-0 count now to Bridges. And especially towards the bottom of the lineup, you want to be able to get ahead of those batters. You don't want them to turn over the lineup card with a bunch of runners on base. Patton able to get that play. It was a close play at first, much closer than it should have been on a chopping ball to first base.
A little too nonchalant over there by Patton, but good hustle by Noah Bridges right out of the box, not letting Patton go too easy.
So now Greg Jones, the shortstop, will come up for his second at-bat of the game. First at-bat, he drew a leadoff walk in this game. First pitch to him, brushing him off the plate a little bit.
Hinton tried going inside against him his first at-bat, too.
Hinton's having a hard time establishing the plate. It's the next delivery. Pretty similar pitch, but a different outcome. We'll get a called strike there. As Hinton looking for the signs from Miller for the 1-1 delivery. And it'll be hit up the middle, so Jones with a base hit. And it's bobbled by Mahan at shortstop, so Jones able to advance to second. Just seems like the outfield play for the Blue Hens all around, not too great today.
Yeah, two mishaps, and it's only the third inning.
And especially you don't expect that from someone like Kevin Mahalan, the junior out there, who is such a centerpiece in that center field role for the Hens.
Center fielder's the captain out there in the outfield, and you got to rely on them to make those plays.
Now Lyles will come to the plate. He tried to bunt last time. Didn't work out too well for him. First pitch called strike, so because of that, Hutchins moved in a little bit over there at third base. Hutchins is playing at the grass-painted turf here at Bob Hanna Stadium. And Vicone is holding Jones close at second base. Delivery missing outside. Now it's a 1-1 count. Lyles in his last at bat flied out to Baker after trying to put down a bunt. He almost popped out to Miller behind the plate off a bunt, but Miller was unable to get that ball. So now the 1-1 delivery from Hinton. Checked his swing and it'll miss outside, so now it's 2-1 count to the Seahawks right fielder. Hinton has been, he's struggled so far the first part time through the first half of the lineup, and now he's struggling again through this part of the lineup. As he'll check the runner at second base, keep him honest over there at second. And keep an eye over there at Jones. He'll deliver home as it hits foul ball behind home plate. Evens up the count at 2-2.
Want to go after Lyles here with Jeffers and Byrne coming up to follow.
So Hinton to deliver the 2-2 pitch. Just missing, now be a full count. A lot of full counts so far by Hinton.
It was a good spot with two strikes, trying to go in on him, trying to get the swinging strike, but didn't get it.
So now Hinton will be in another full count situation. and it'll deliver. The runner goes to third, and it's just overthrown. So it'll be a walk, and the run will score, and that will allow Lyles to advance all the way to second base. So they're going to rule that it was a stolen base for Jones at third base, and then he got home on the error, and then Lyles got the walk and was able to advance to second.
Delaware's just not playing crisp baseball right now. Two errors already in the game, and it's only the third inning. And both of them were costly errors, leading to two runs.
And especially for a pitcher, you have to trust the guys behind you. And maybe right now, Hinton can't really trust those guys behind him. It's already been three mishaps.
And as a catcher, too, there's a lefty batter up there, so there's no right-handed batter you have to go around to catch a runner stealing third. So he had a clear shot at third base and saw the runner going, just airmailed it all the way to the left field wall.
And Jones also got a good jump over there. Even if it was a great throw by Miller, he probably would have been out anyways. So you have to think about whether Miller really should have thrown the ball, whether that the freshman, where that decision-making needed to come into play. So now Ryan Jeffers, the catcher for the Seahawks, will come to the plate with a runner at second base.
Delaware could use another double play here like Jeffers hit into his last at-bat.
Called strike one. His slugging percentage on the year, .714. Someone that really puts a lot of power in any time he makes contact with it. We even saw it on the first time when he hit a liner to second base. The 0-1 delivery from Hinton. Just missed inside. Took something off of that. Evens up the count at 1-1.
Keeping Jeffers honest at the plate. Going away and now inside. Not going to let him guess his pitches here.
Blue Hens already two errors in today's game. Have been two costly errors. Both allowing runners to score. Hinton's delivery. It'll be hit to short. Vacone looks the runner back. It'll throw to Patton at first. A good scoop there by Patton at first base.
It was a good scoop. That's a good good pitch, though, by Hinton, getting the ground ball, especially to the left side. The runner could have advanced to third.
So now coming to the plate will be Mason Byrne, the first baseman for the Seahawks in his first at-bat. Flied out to center field. And we'll try to get out of this inning with only the one run scored. The delivery will be fouled off behind home plate. 0-1 count now to the first baseman for the Seahawks. And taking a lot of deep breaths over there at the pitcher's mound. Looking Lyles, making sure he doesn't get too big of a lead. The delivery almost got burned to chase after, but Byrne able to hold up. It's a 1-1 count now.
Yeah, good late movement on that pitch too, which almost forced Byrne into chasing that pitch.
And you got to be worried a little bit about Kyle Hinton's pitch count. This will be pitch number 50 for Hinton. Not even through the third inning yet. The delivery will be a called strike, so now it's a 1-2 count to Mason Byrne, the first baseman for the Seahawks.
Two strikes here for him, but you don't want to take a chance against Byrne. He could come back and he could take advantage of that.
And taking his good old time over there. And we'll come set for the 1-2 delivery.
Big pitch.
Took something off of it, just missing up high. Two balls, two strikes. Kind of good that he missed with his miss that wasn't lower, wasn't in the strike zone, because Byrne could have hit that far away.
That was hanging there for him. If it was a little bit lower, I could still be going.
Byrne could have hit his 9th home run of the year. So if you're a catcher, you're not too upset with that pitch missing there. And then Hinn goes to second and will get Lyles in a rundown. as they will finally make the tag. The Blue Hens, a little crafty defense to get out of it after one run, one hit, three errors. 2-0 UNCW will go to the bottom of the third. Stadium, as we have a little bit of Friday the 13th baseball going on here at the campus of the University of Delaware.
Don't scare me like that.
Vinny Vaccone will come to the plate for the Hens. The first pitch will miss, ball one. So it'll be Vaccone, and then as we top of the order, Mahalan and Bowron to follow in the do up. Vaccone on the year, only a 149 batter.
Nice to see if Vaccone can get on base here. As right on cue.
Poke into right field where Lyles is playing. Lyles running to that ball faster than when he was caught in that rundown to end the inning. And the Blue Hens have a leadoff runner on with now the top of the lineup and Kevin Mahalan coming to the plate.
That's what I was going to say. It'd be nice to get Vaccone on with the top of the order coming up. And he couldn't even let me finish talking.
Mahalan last at bat, lined out into center field. Still batting average over 300, 302 now after that first at bat. Vaccone taking his lead off first base. He's stolen three bases this year, has been caught stealing four times. Royalty comes in, delivers, miss up high, the heater missing up high to Mahalan. Ball one, 1-0 count now. As they'll get their signs from Coach Sherman over there at third base. A 1-0 delivery to Mahalan. So miss, very close pitch, 2-0 count now. Royalty falling behind against Mahalan. The delivery. Mahalan hits it to third, and Weiss unable to get it. It'll be a base hit as Vaccone will go all the way to third, and that's what he'll stop. Mahalan advances to second base. Now the Blue Hens, two runners in scoring position with no outs.
You can always count on Mahalan to get on base at least a couple times, and there he goes with the double down the line. Just misplayed by the third baseman. I guess it didn't take the hop he was expecting.
Number three, Eric Bowron.
So now coming to play, Eric Bowron, the second baseman, struck out looking last at bat. Bowron could tie this game up for the Blue Hens with a base hit. Mahalan, great speed over there at second base. That's a little chopper down third base line. It's going to be a tough play. Weiss throws over to first, and he's safe. A base hit, and now runners on the corner, no outs, and now it's a 2-1 Seahawks lead.
Great speed getting the first base, too, by Bowen. Tough play for the third baseman to charge in on that chopper. But
now a little mound visit coming for the Seahawks. No one yet up in their bullpen. No action in either bullpen, but this is a crucial part of the game right now for Royalty in the bottom of the third. Already runners on the corners, no outs. And now you have the meat of your lineup coming in Baker, Patton, and Scott.
Yeah, Baker leading the team in RBIs. It'd be nice if he could add to his tally here with hitting in Mahalan from third. Yeah. Maybe if he gets a gapper, he could score two.
Baker has good speed and good power at the plate. Not a home run hitter, only one home run on the year, but six doubles and three triples already on the year. Baker will try to get something going for the Hens right now, batting 323.
Still in double play depth, UNCW.
Royalty comes set and delivers as it's hit to Jones. He'll throw it over to second base, and it's bobbled by Meadows, unable to come up with it, and it'll be everybody safe. And now we have a tight game.
Either way, the run was going to score, but there would have been at least one out. I think Baker would have beat that out at first. But now still nobody out for the Blue Hens here in the inning.
So Baker will reach on a fielder's choice and an error. I think they will charge him with on the second baseman. He reached last time on a Meadows error. So Baker kind of loving hitting the ball in Meadows' area. And now coming to the plate, Nick Patton. Two runners on and a tie game, no one out.
Holding him tight at second.
Delivery missing outside. Now this is where the Blue Hens bats become patient and make Royalty come to them.
Yeah, Royalty hasn't really had to pitch from the stretch too much today. And this inning's been in the stretch the whole time.
As Jeffers goes to talk to his pitcher, calming down a little bit. The infield for the Seahawks shaded over just a little bit to the left. Burns not holding Baker on at first base, but rather covering that gap in between him and Meadows. The delivery, Patton hits it to Jones, a diving stop. They'll go to second, then to first, and they get the double play. So it'll be two outs now. Runners now at third base for the Hens, and here comes Calvin Scott.
Hit that too hard. It was a great play by Jones, though, going to his backhand. And a quick transfer to second base to start the double play.
And if that ball was just hit
a little bit more to the left.
Or a little bit slower, Pat would have beat that out.
And it's an unearned run. Now that he designated hitter number six, Calvin Scott.
Royalty will come set to the first pitch to Scott. Gets a swing and a miss. Took something off that. Fooled Scott a little bit there. Scott's first at bat. He grounded out to second base. Infield playing back on him. Middle infielders playing on the outfield turf. And then another swing and a miss from Scott. Quickly 0-2. He'll take his time out of the box. Think about this a little bit more. Royalty shaking off the first one from Jeffers. Now it comes set. It's a chopper to Weiss. The throw does not get Scott. They're going to say Byrne was off the base. He can't believe it. So another run will score, and now the Hens take the lead, 3-2.
Even if he was off the base, looked like Scott might have beat it out anyway. But either way, good hustle by Scott to force the rush throw.
It's a hard ball to field. The chopping ball on this turf has been a problem so far for the Seahawks today.
Weiss played it well, though. He got the hop that he wanted and was set up for a nice, easy throw.
As now Chance DeFebo will come up to the plate. Blue Hens with now a one-run lead. As they'll check over at Scott at first base. He has dive back, but is in there safely.
They saw the speed he had to get him to first. It might be a threat to go now.
DeFebo trying to keep this going for the Hens. That'll be fouled off. DeFebo taking a little bit of time looking at Coach Sherman at third base, trying to figure out. Come set. So he looks like it hit him in the box, and they will call foul ball eventually. And second base umpire was saying that hit him in the box.
Home plate umpire, my bad, too.
DeFebo will get back in there after that foul ball. 184 so far on the year. Royalty will try to get out this inning that has been dreadful for him so far. Delivery misses outside. Scott goes, and a bad throw. Scott almost went to third base, but will wisely hold up at second base.
It was like a delayed steal, too, by Scott. He didn't take off right away. Lucky with the errant throw to the outfield. Both catchers now having trouble throwing the runners out, trying to steal.
It looks like Jeffers was throwing to where Meadows is playing normally, not to the bag.
Yeah, but as a catcher, you're taught from when you're little, throw the ball to the base. The second baseman or shortstop has to get there. If they're not there, it's their own fault.
Two outs. They're not going to really hold Scott on. He has a huge lead over there at second base. The delivery, Febo fouling it off down the first base line, staying alive.
Battling right now. Making him work on the mound. Getting his pitch count up, too.
That's what you want from the freshman at the plate for DeFebo. Make this pitcher work. Get into their bullpen and get Royalty out of the game.
Especially the sooner you get to the bullpen, the more pitchers that have to be used, and it's a long weekend ahead of us here.
Come set. Keeps looking over there at Scott. Then DeFebo, a chopper to Weiss. It's been a hard play over there for him, but he's able to make that play. The Blue Hens bats come back and take the lead in this inning. Three runs on three hits and two errors. We'll head to the top of the fourth. Blue Hens leading this game 3-2.
Together again, under one roof, for one incredible tour. Newsboys United, all the hits.
This is Entertaining Angels.
And one amazing concert coming soon to a city near you. Newsboys United. United.
My God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the inside.
Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium. Blue Hens taking the lead in the bottom of the third and now hitting back out there for the fourth inning. Mason Byrne at the plate fouls the first pitch off. Mason Byrne, he has a lot of power at the plate. Flied out to center field in his first at bat. And the next pitch, a strike. So quickly 0-2 to a power hitter.
Nice to see him coming out here and throwing strikes right off the bat after his team just gave him the lead.
So Hannon comes, set the delivery, missing outside, trying to go hard and away.
Just missed the spot a little bit too much. He wanted to go away, but not that far away.
So it'll be a 1-2 count now to Byrne, batting 368 on the year. Hinton's delivery be fouled off behind home plate, so we'll remain a 1-2 count.
It's been going with the heater so far against Byrne. Let's see if he'll take a chance and go off speed. Change up his timing at the plate.
Normal depth for both the infield and outfield. Fouled it off for another 1-2 count.
Just got a piece of it, too.
And taking a little bit longer. Think about this next pitch. He's thinking Byrne keeps fouling off these 1-2 pitches. What do I have to go with here? Hinton comes set the delivery, missing once again outside. So the two balls in this at-bat have both missed outside. So now a 2-2 count to Byrne. Byrne trying to get something going for the Seahawks offense, trying to get them back tied up or take the lead in this game. And then the next pitch, they'll ring him up, tried to hold back but couldn't. So a strikeout for Hinton.
Good tough at bat by Byrne. Made Hinton work, but in the end, Hinton won the battle.
Hinton with his first strikeout of the day. Now coming to the plate, left fielder Zach Canada in his first at bat. Grounded out to Hutchins over there at third base. Hutchins playing in on the grass painted turf over there at third base. First pitch to him. Hits the outside corner for a called strike, 0-1. So that was Hinton's 60th pitch thrown so far. Still no action in the Blue Hens bullpen. Hinton's 0-1 delivery gets a swing and a miss from Canada. Now with the two strikes, Hutchins will move back into his normal depth over there at third base.
Again, Hinton getting two strikes quickly on a batter here in this inning.
Delivery. It'll be hit to left field to Febo. Right near the warning track, and the Blue Monster will make the catch. Wasn't a pretty catch, but nonetheless, it is an out.
Lucky out, too, for Hinton. Looked like he missed his spot there, 0-2, and almost came back to haunt him. 0-2, you don't want to put that ball anywhere near the strike zone, and that ball almost ended up out of the park.
Ball just kept carrying. That wind is going,
it's going that way.
Back into left field, and now Blake Deathridge will come to the plate. His first at-bat, a single. First pitch of this at-bat was a ball. The next delivery from Hinton, it will be hit to DeFebo in left field once again, and DeFebo is able to make
that would look much easier.
Made it look much easier over there in left field. DeFebo making up, I guess, for those two, for that one blunder out there in left field. We're gonna go to the bottom of the fourth. Delaware leading this game 3-2.
Hi, guys.
guys. So this is the all-new Chevy Equinox.
It's gorgeous.
It offers heated and ventilated front seats, heated rear seats, a panoramic sunroof, built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, Apple CarPlay compatibility, surround vision, safety alert seat, and teen driver technology.
All of that is in this one car.
Yeah, and to get all these features, you would have to buy all five of those crossovers.
Whoa.
Oh, and the Lexus NX.
That's insane.
Yep, all six of these, and you still wouldn't get everything that's in this Equinox.
Chevy's raising the bar.
Six cars in one.
I like that.
Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium. We head to the bottom of the fourth inning. Blue Hens leading this game 3-2, and they were able to take that score those three runs in the last inning, and now they'll try to feed off of it. Jordan Hutchins, the third baseman, will come to the plate. He doubled down the right field line his last at bat. Now he'll lay down a bunt down the third baseline. Weiss will glove it and throw it over and just gets Hutchins over there at first.
Just beat him by a half a step. Good play, though, by Weiss at third.
So it was a good bunt by Hutchins hugging the third baseline. Weiss wasn't expecting that. And now coming to the plate will be catcher Zach Miller. His last at bat grounded out to Weiss over there at third base.
Weiss and Meadows both getting a lot of action here in the infield for UNCW.
First pitch to him.
Just a little outside.
Just a bit outside over there. 1-0 count now.
You're copying me, Michael.
The 1-0 delivery, we fouled off. Getting a piece of it was Miller, even up the count at 1-1. This will be Royalty's 54th pitch thrown today coming up. Royalty's delivery will be a chopper to Jones. We've seen that's been a problem today for the Seahawks infield, but it's not that time, so easily throw it over to Byrne. So quickly, two outs for the Hens. And now Vinny Vaccone, the shortstop, will try to get something going for this Blue Hens offense.
Started the rally for the Blue Hens in the last inning with that single. And later scored too.
Blue Hens today 1-1 for 6, batting with two away. And Vaccone will take the first pitch for a ball. The 1-0 delivery, as Vaccone showed bunt, pulled it back, but it will be a called strike anyway. Sherman not really happy over there at third base, so even up the count at 1-1.
Yeah, Weiss is playing deep at third. If he dropped one down third, he could have had a chance to beat that one out too.
Weiss still playing deep over there at third. He'll foul this one off. It's now a 1-2 count in favor of Royalty.
Now with two strikes, Weiss doesn't even have to worry about the bunt.
The 1-2 delivery will miss down low. It's now a 2-2 count to Vinny Vaccone. On the year, 11 walks, 32 strikeouts for the Blue Hens shortstop. As he'll get a swing and a miss, Royalty gets the Blue Hens 1-2-3. We'll see Cole Weiss coming up to the plate, leading off for the Seahawks in the top of the fifth. No runs, no hits, or no errors. We go to the top of the fifth. Blue Hens leading this game 3-2.
How do you want to live? As a decent person? Good husband? Is that it? Good? Of course not. King of the hill? Better. Top of your game? Win. All powerful. Like a boss. Like a pro. We couldn't agree more. We are professional grade. Step up to GMC with over 11,500 total value on a specially equipped Sierra SLT crew cab model when you finance through GM Financial. We are professional grade. GMC.
together again under one roof for one incredible tour. Newsboys United, all the hits.
This is Entertaining Angels.
And one amazing concert coming soon to a city near you. Newsboys United.
My God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the
inside. Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium. Cole Weiss. First at batter for the Seahawks, a diving stop by Vinny Vaccone to catch it. It's quickly one out for the Seahawks.
That's nice to start the inning. One pitch, one out for Kyle Hinton, especially with his pitch count getting up there here in the fifth inning.
That was 65th pitch just thrown. During the middle, during that, the end of that inning, Nick Spadafino was outside the dugout, just stretching a little bit. No action yet in the bullpen as then DeFebo will fall down once again over there in left field, and a base hit for Jackson Meadows.
We have to check his cleats, I think. It's twice he's already fallen down there in left field.
And right on cue, he grabs his right leg, making sure that his cleat's still there. So now Noah Bridges, the center fielder, will come to the plate for the Seahawks. So he'll have a runner on first base in Meadows. Hinton will come set the delivery. So there's a pitch out. Nothing going on, though. Meadows on the year, two stolen bases, has not been caught all year. As after Bridges, it will be the top of the lineup, Jones and Lyles to follow. And then we'll check over there at first base to Meadows. But he's back in there safely.
Meadows only two stolen bases on the year. They're keeping an eye on him pretty closely here.
As Hinton keeps a close eye over there at first base, and he goes. And it'll be fouled off, out of play, down the third base line. But there was Meadows going.
I guess Delaware has a better scouting report than we do. Only two stolen bases on the year, but a pitch out, a throw over, and he was going on that pitch, so.
And now you got to
maybe a hit and run.
Wonder if they will send Meadows again. Blue Hens defense in double play depth. I'm set. Meadows goes again. Another looks like hit and run.
Must be hit and run, yep. Because that was up, too, but he swung at it anyway, so. Two strikes now.
1-2 will be interesting. See if they'll still have that hit and run on for Meadows and Bridges at the plate. Bridges able to fight through a couple of hard pitches to foul them off. Hand comes set. Delivery. Just got a piece of
good
it.
Good pitch.
So it'll remain a 1-2 count. Bridges just staying alive at the plate. On the year, Bridges with 39 strikeouts so far. Only 27 hits.
It's not a good sign when you have more strikeouts than hits.
As Henning will come set and check over to the runner at first, but he's back in there safely.
That was a quick throw over. That was a good move.
Hinton has a 1-2 count. Check over the runner once again at first base. Hinton keeping a very close eye over there at first base in Meadows. Bridges at the plate. 1-2 count. The delivery with Meadows going will be fouled off once again behind the plate.
There wasn't a net here. I was catching that ball, just so you know.
Seems like every time this hit and run's been on, Bridge is just able to foul it off, not able to put the ball actually in play.
Well, that's what you got to do. If you can't get it in play, you just got to at least get some kind of contact on it so the runner isn't out to dry.
You have to know that Hinton is probably thinking that they're going, and now a pitch out. Meadows started to go, saw the pitch out, and quickly goes back to first base. So that was a smart call by the Delaware coaching staff. Keep Meadows honest over there. Hinton will come set 2-2 count and check over at the runner over there at first once again.
Meadows was leading a little bit too towards second.
Meadows and Bridges look for the signs over there at third. For the 2-2 delivery from Hinton. As Meadows goes, it will be fouled off once again down the third baseline.
Meadows is getting his cardio in for today.
You have to think that how many times Meadows has gone and there's been a foul ball. If there's a gapper, it might...
He's going to be exhausted.
It's going to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. Longest so far of the day. All Bridges can do is foul it off. Still a 2-2 count. Meadows over there at first base. He goes once again. And it'll be low. And they're going to get him out at second base. Meadows can't believe it. But it'll be a full count now at the plate for Bridges.
He just can't believe it, but he's also probably out of breath. That's the first time Bridges didn't swing too at a ball where Meadows was going. So I guess the hit and run was off, and it was just a straight steal.
Good throw by Miller to get him.
Perfect throw. Right on the bag.
Now full count, and now Hinton can get out of this without the lineup switching over. And as I say that, it's a walk to Bridges. So after that, it'll be a 10-pitch at-bat, and he draws a walk. So now we'll flip the lineup card over, and Greg Jones, the leadoff batter, shortstop, will come to the plate. 1-for-1 on the day with a walk and a base hit up the middle.
Yep, he's doing what a leadoff batter is supposed to do. Got on base twice already today.
And will come set the delivery. The outside looked almost like another pitch out. Bridges over there at first base. 8 stolen bases on the year, only been caught once this year. Someone else that can run over there at first base. Hutchins playing in over there at third base for the Blue Hens. Delivery, be a called strike, evens up the count at 1-1. Hinton about to throw his 79th pitch of the day. Still no action in the Blue Hens bullpen. Has now checked the runner over there at first base. He's back in there safely. Hinton. Try to get out of this inning unharmed. Already 2 away. The pitch. Swing and a miss. It's now a 1-2 count to Jones.
Well, it's some drop to it from hitting. Jones swung right over it.
Jones was swinging out of his cleats over there. And we'll try to get out of this inning, can do so with one pitch. The runner goes, and they throw a pitch out, and Bridges would have been safe at second probably. However, he slid past the bag at second base, the turf, playing advantage to the Blue Hens.
Turf monster on Friday the 13th.
No runs, one hit, no errors. We'll go to the bottom of the fifth. Blue Hens leading this game 3-2. Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium. The turf being friendly to the Blue Hens on Friday the 13th, as that helped them throw out Bridges over there at second base, just kind of sliding right through the base. Now the Blue Hens will get their leadoff batter up, start the bottom of the fifth inning in Kevin Mahalan. The first pitch to Mahalan, be a called strike. So Mahalan on the day, 1-for-2, lined out center field, also a double today. Next pitch, another off-speed pitch in there for another called strike, quickly 0-2 to Mahalan.
Mahalan wasn't ready for that curve there. He's sitting fastball, it looks like. Trying to get something he could drive. Now two strikes, just gotta choke him on the bat and protect. Try to get him chasing.
Ball was in the turf at home plate. That'll be 1-2 count now to the Blue Hens center fielder. Batting 308 now on the year. She delivers. And it'll be hit to Weiss over there at third. Mahalan will just get thrown out. It looked like he was looking over there at Weiss, something you should never do as a base runner.
Weiss was took a couple clutches, too, over there at third. Not something you should do with Mahalan running down the base path.
So now coming to play, Eric Boren. 1-for-2 on the day. Strikeout looking and a single. RBI single. The first pitch from Royalty, be a little chopper down third baseline, but it'll be hit him in the box. It's close to being a fair ball, though, if it didn't hit him.
I think it was fair if it didn't hit him. I didn't even know it hit him.
It's an 0-1 count now to Boren. Royalty taking his good old time over there at the mound. The 0-1 will miss. 1-1 count now.
That was pretty close to hitting Bowen. He didn't even flinch. Later in the game, Royalty's taking a lot more time on the mound than compared to earlier in the game.
Delivery will miss once again. It's now a 2-1 count. Royalty starting to get up there in pitches in the high 60s now. The delivery miss once again. It's a 3-1 count now to the Blue Hens second baseman.
Hitter's count here for Bowen. 3-1 count. You can sit fastball. Something he can't drive, he should not take the bat off of his shoulder.
Bowen only 3 extra base hits on the year as he fouls that one off. Now be a full count now to Bowen. Trying to get something going for the Blue Hens with one away in the bottom of the fifth inning. Pitch to Bowen is hit out to left center field. Bridges and Canada coming over. Canada able to make the play. Now two outs for the Blue Hens with Kyle Baker coming to the plate. Baker on the day. He reached twice, both on errors or fielder's choice in one at-bat. Error to Meadows in his first at-bat. And then he got an RBI fielder's choice when Jones tried to turn the double play and Meadows unable to come up with it. As be a ball bouncing away from the catcher. So 1-0 count now to Baker. With his last at-bat now, 21 RBIs on the year for the Blue Hens right fielder. As Baker swings and misses through one.
Back foot slid out on that one too for Baker.
Blue Hens have not been able to get anything going with two away. One for seven today. So miss once again. 2-1 is now the count. Baker in there for the 2-1 count. Right from royalty. The delivery. Miss once again. Now a 3-1 count. Back-to-back batters. He's at a 3-1 counts. Now royalty will take his good old time. Tie his shoes a little bit. Make sure they're all laced up.
You don't want to be tripping out there on the mound. Safety first, Michael.
Royalty to deliver the 3-1 pitch. Baker thought about it, but then decided to hold up, and he will draw a walk, his sixth on the season. And now coming to the plate, Nick Pannon, trying to extend his on-base streak to 21 games, yet to get on base.
First baseman, number 20, Nick Pannon.
See if they can get a two-out rally going, too, here in the bottom of the fifth.
Royalty at 75 pitches for the Seahawks. So take a long look over there at Baker at first base. The delivery. Pan hits that to center field. Bridges backing up on it. Bridges jumping over, and it hits the batter's eye. A home run. Blue Hens extend their lead 5-2.
Right on cue, you just said, extend his on-base streak. He's not going to be on base for long, but either way, home run from Nick Patton.
He also extends his hit streak now to 8 games. It's his 4th home run of the season, RBIs 12 and 13 for Patton on the year. Has a rowdy bunch over there greeting him.
That was a shot, too, for Nick Patton, dead center.
Deep center, hitting the left part of that batter's eye in center field. And now come in and play Calvin Scott, who also has a little pop in his bat. As Scott, a chopper to Weiss, almost went over his head. Scott going to try to leg it out and unable to. So that's how the inning will end. But not before Nick Pan extends the Blue Hens lead 5-2 off of a home run as Calvin Scott not able to get anything going after that. We'll head to the top of the sixth inning. Blue Hens leading this game 5-2. Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium. Top of the sixth inning. McPann extending the Blue Hens lead 5-2 off a two-run shot to deep center field. And now the top of the Seahawks lineup will come to the plate with Greg Jones, the shortstop.
It's nice to give Kyle Hinton some more run support here in the top of the sixth.
Makes Mahalan back up on it, but easily makes the grab one away. So that was Hinton's 82nd pitch so far today. And now coming to the plate will be Noah Lyles, freshman right fielder. So far today, flew out to Baker at in right field and has also walked. First pitch, a swing and a miss from Lyles. And has been making very good work recently. The second and third innings were giving him a little bit of trouble, but since then, no runs given up by him.
The defense has also helped him.
Next pitch, just missing just a bit outside. Evens up the count at 1-1 to Lyles. You want to make sure that you can try to get Lyles out here with Jefferson Byrne following. A little blooper into left center field. DeFebo unable to make the catch. Try to make a diving catch.
Great hustle. Good effort there by DeFebo. Just found a hole right in between the triangle out there, left center and the shortstop.
And now, with a runner at first base, catcher Ryan Jeffers will come to the plate on the day. 0-2. The two biggest hitters, two most powerful hitters in this lineup, Blue Hens have held 0-4 on the day. Jeffers will come on with the runner at first base. The first pitch, we popped up behind home plate. Will there be room for Miller? And it just curved back. Miller unable to make that catch.
The wind coming into play there, bringing it back.
So now we see the flags in right field blowing more towards center field. The flags there just past the, right next to the scoreboard, which has the conference championship banner. So it'll be an 0-1 count now to Jeffers. Hens in comes set. The delivery. Be fouled down the third base line.
A 2 count now. Hens got a couple pitches to play with, but he's still got to be smart with a runner on first base.
Because now we see redshirt senior Coleman Villa warming up in the Hens bullpen. So Hinton trying to get out of this. 0-2 to Jeffers. Delivery just outside, just a bit. Tried to get Jeffers to chase him, make it a 1-2 count with one away runner at first base. So we saw a couple relievers go out to the pen, but Coleman Villa the only one warming up so far. The delivery. Be fouled off down the right field line, out of play, or remain a 1-2 count. Coleman Villa continuing to warm up the lefty. Hinton up there in pitches. Check the runner over there first. Back in there safely. Lyles has no stolen bases on the year, has been caught 4 times so far this year. The delivery just missing. Evens up the count at 2-2.
He's used his 2 pitches now to play around with. Now he's going to go right after Jeffers and sit him down here.
And you have to think, when would they bring in Coleman Villa? Next 3 batters after Jeffers, all righties, and then you have Weiss, the lefty.
Important for him to keep the ball low, though. Maybe get a ground ball double play.
Runner started to go, then stopped. A diving stop by Hutchins. Will just go over to first, but Penn unable to get the tag. The ball popped out, so it'll be a base hit. Now runners at first and second for Byrne.
Got the ground ball he wanted, just Jeffers got a decent amount of piece of it. Good play by Hutchins over at third to keep that in the infield.
It was a hard ball to field over there for Hutchins. It's good, though, that he kept it in the infield. Did not let the runners go past first and second base, especially with a guy like Mason Byrne at the plate, slugging percentage of .652, batting .372 with runners in scoring position. As a little talk on the mound, this might be just talking to him about how to get out of this inning without too much harm. He does have the 3-run lead to play with.
Talking to him how to get Byrne out too, because one swing of the bat and Byrne can tie this game up with 2 runners on base. So tell him, be smart, but you can't put him on here and load the bases.
To follow Byrne would be Zach Canada, the left fielder for the Seahawks. As they'll get signs from their third base coach. Burns stepping in there, big guy, 6'4", 245 at the plate. A healthy strike zone over there for him to throw into. First pitch will get in the lower half of that strike zone for a called strike one, 0-1 count.
Born get a first pitch strike right there.
Hinnon, look for the signs. The delivery will miss just outside to even up the count at 1-1.
Good pitch by Hinnon. You don't want to put the ball over the plate here against Byrne. Keep it on the corners.
Jeffers not being huddled at first base. Lyles, a nice lead over there at second base. And a called strike on the outer half. Byrne not liking that call at all.
Good placement, though, by Hinnon. Hitting the outside corner. Now with 2 strikes. Probably going to go away again. He's gone away every pitch so far in this at-bat to Byrne.
Hinnon will come set. One away. Looking for a double play ball. And instead, he'll just get a swing and a miss from Byrne. It's a big out right there for Kyle Hinton.
Went away again, just like he did on the previous pitch. Got the swing and miss this time, though. Got him the chase.
And now Zach Canada, the left fielder, will come up for the Seahawks. And now Hinton's just one out away from getting out of this inning unharmed.
One out away from probably finishing his day as well. Finishing a good outing.
And taking a long look at home plate for Miller, and then will come set the delivery. Miss outside for a ball. So it'll be a 1-0 count now to Canada, the left fielder. He's grounded out to Hutchins and also flown out to DeFebo. So been hitting it to the left side of the field so far today. Hens 1-0 delivery. Get a swing and a miss. Probably chase that a little bit. Evens up the count at 1-1. Hinton. Canada still has that power. 5 home runs on the year, 5 doubles, and 1 triple. Delivery. We got called strike. Canada not liking that call. It'll be a 1-2 count now to the Seahawks left fielder.
Hinton's been living on the outside corner for the last 2 batters right now. He's found that spot pretty well, too, and he's going to continue to hit it.
We saw when he was struggling at the early half of the game, he wasn't able to find that outside corner at all. It was always a ball way outside. Time will be called at home plate. So Hinnon will step off. And will come set for the 1-2 delivery, missing it just outside.
Again, trying to go outside, though.
And one strike away from getting out of this inning, but it is a 2-2 count now. Lyles at second base, Jeffers at first base for the Seahawks. Canada trying to extend this inning and will foul it off, just getting a piece of it.
He just missed that too. He's on the fastball right now. He's hitting, tries to change it up with a breaking ball away. Still going to stay away though.
And taking his time over there. The delivery will go to third base. Hutchins will go to second base. Get the out. The Blue Hens will escape that inning unharmed. No runs, two hits, no errors. As we will head to the bottom of the sixth, Blue Hens leading this game 5-2.
Here's your chance to win big and adventure bigger on the Powerball Power Cruise on board Royal Caribbean's Majesty of the Seas. Play Powerball today and enter to be one of the lucky winners of an exclusive adventure of a lifetime. You'll enjoy a private concert featuring Kenny Loggins and even get a shot at $250,000 in cash prizes on board. The only way to get on board is to play Powerball and enter to win big.
Six Delaware Lottery players will win. Visit delottery.com for details. Want to play?
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium, 5-2 as we head to the bottom of the sixth inning. Michael Bond will join alongside Danny Letty. And we'll see Royalty go back out there for another inning of work at 77 pitches. Four of those five runs earned runs so far against him.
Yeah, I mean, other than that one inning where the Delaware put up three runs, although there wasn't much help defensively for Royalty, the one bad pitch to Patton for the home run gives the Delaware this 5-2 lead and gives Royalty the four earned runs.
And now coming to the plate, Chance DeFebo, the left fielder. He's grounded out to both Meadows at second base and Weiss at third base. So DeFebo will try to get something going. First pitch to him, he'll hit it to Meadows at second base. Fields and throws over to first for the first out. One pitch, one out for Royalty.
It's a good start for Royalty. Trying to finish this sixth inning with the high pitch count. One pitch, one out. Can't get better than that. As UNCW is sending pitchers to the bullpen right now. I saw about three pitchers go. I'm not sure who's warming up.
So now both bullpens active. First pitch now to Hutchins will miss for a ball.
Royalty seems to have lost the release point for his curve. He had it going in the first two innings, but that one just missed high.
And that'll be hit over to Meadows, a sharp hit. Ball, and it'll be an out. So it only takes three pitches so far to get two outs. And now coming up to the plate, Zach Miller. That'll be a chopper down the third base line. Foul ball. So it'll be an 0-1 count now to Miller. And he'll just get a piece of it. Tried to extend the lead to 6-2 there.
He was early on that one, too. That one ball would have been pulled right down the line. Outside pitch, too. Way ahead of it.
So it's quickly 0-2 count. The delivery just a little bit outside for a ball 1-2 count.
Royalty could get Miller here. This is the inning that he needed and UNCW needed to start to get back into this ball game. A quick inning.
The delivery. Be a swing and a miss. The tag out will finish off Miller. Coming up for UNCW, 6-7-8 in the top of the seventh inning. No runs, no hits, no errors. We'll go to top seven. Blue Hens still leading this game, 5-2. Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium. Pitching change for the Blue Hens. Coleman Villa will come in. He started the CAA championship game last year against UNCW. Now he'll come in for relief on the year. Pretty good stats. 1.56 ERA, 2-2 on the year. And this will be his 13th appearance. Two saves in 17 and a third innings pitch with 23 strikeouts and only 7 walks.
Yeah, I was going to say, only those 17 innings he's got. 23 strikeouts, so over strikeout per inning here for Villa.
This will be a strike on the first pitch quickly, 0-1. There's more action in the Blue Hens bullpen. Meeker is also up and throwing for the Hens. Delivery, be another called strike, quickly 0-2.
Good start coming in right out of the bullpen throwing strikes. It's a good sign for Delaware and Villa.
Villa will come set for the 0-2. Almost got Deathridge to chase, but he's able to hold up. The delivery brushed him off the plate a little bit. So now it'll be a 2-2 count to Deathridge.
Using the full plate, too, to start. Going inside and outside.
The delivery will be hit into right field. Baker will play it off a hop. And Deathridge now 2-for-3 on the day.
Good at bat for Deathridge after falling behind. 0-2.
Now coming to the plate, Cole Weiss, third baseman. And now we'll see a lefty. Lefty matchup. Coleman Villa, who just came in, is a lefty, and now he'll see the only one of two lefties in this lineup, two switch hitters in this lineup, but only two true lefties. Long look over there first, but then we'll deliver a chopper to Boren, and he'll just go to first base. Throws it over to Penn for the easy out. So it'll be one away with a runner on second base. It's Deatherage at second base.
Smart play by Boren, too. It was a slowly hit ball to second, and he gave the runner a look, but noticed he wouldn't get him in time to turn two. So just took the easy out at first, especially with a three-run lead.
Jackson Meadows, the second baseman for the Seahawks, will come to the plate. Delivery from Villa. Be a called strike. Meadows not liking that call at all. Deatherage not attempted a stolen base yet this year. With runners in scoring position, the Seahawks are 0-5 today. Villa delivers. Swing and a miss. He got a big swing and a miss. Man. 0-2.
So Meadows was late on that pitch, too. Tried killing it.
Sevilla has Meadows 0-2. Runner on second base. One away in the top of the seventh. And now Villa will ask for the signs once again. Meadows will step out, take a little breather himself. The delivery, he gets a swing and a miss, a strikeout for Coleman Villa against Jackson Meadows, and now Bridges will come to the plate with two away.
Center fielder number 22, Noah Bridges.
See if Villa can finish his inning here after giving up the leadoff single to Deatherage.
So we'll get another lefty-lefty matchup. The other lefty in this lineup, Bridges, coming to the plate. 0-for-1 so far today for the Seahawks center fielder. They're not holding on Deatherage at all at second base. A healthy lead, and it'll be hit third base. Hutchins unable to handle it. It'll go all the way into center field, and a run will score because of that. So now it's a 5-3 Delaware lead.
The jam Bridges on that pitch, too. And just hit off Hutchins right off the arm. Vacone was going to back him up, and we just put him out of position and let the ball go straight to center field with nobody there.
Just an unlucky bounce right there. Now Villa has a runner on first base, and they're going to say Villa balked. So now Bridges will advance to second base. Now a little discussion. Coach Sherman will come out. Let's go talk to the umpire.
I think the ump saying he looked home a little bit with his front leg.
As the discussion will continue, a couple players. Patton also did not agree with that call. Neither did Villa. So as it stands right now, Bridges will be at second base. Some speed. Coach Sherman still over in between the pitcher's mound and the home plate, talking this one out with the umpire. As now, Coach Sherman will go back to the dugout. So it'll be Bridges at second base with no pitch yet to Jones. Jones, the shortstop for the Seahawks, a switch hitter. He's batted lefty all day today, except for today. Now he'll switch it around, bat righty. Come set the delivery. Yeah, called strike. So it'll be an 0-1 count now. Via comes set for the 0-1 delivery. Just missing a little bit outside.
Miller wanted that for Villa. Tried framing it off the outside corner just too much.
So it's even count at 1-1. This is Villa's 80th appearance all time. Longest school history as Villa called strike 1-2. So now Villa will try to get out of this inning with only the one run given up. Two away, Bridges at second base. The delivery jammed him, and Patton playing a little bit of leapfrog over there at first base to make the out. And now we'll head to the bottom of the seventh inning. One run, one hit on one error. Delaware leading this game 5-3.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Together again, under one roof, for one incredible tour. Newsboys United, all the hits.
This is Entertaining Angels.
And one amazing concert coming soon to a city near you. Newsboys United.
God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the
Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium. We head to the bottom of the seventh inning. Blue Hens leading this game 5-3. Vinny Vaccone will be the leadoff batter. Alex Royalty still out there for the Seahawks. 85 pitches so far today. First pitch will hit the outside corner for a called strike against Vaccone on the day. 1-2 with a single and a strikeout. Follow us on social media, on Twitter, at UD Blue Hens, and on Facebook, Delaware Blue Hens. His next pitch misses for a ball. After Vaccone will be the top of the lineup, Mahalan and Boerin to follow. Vaccone hits it to Jones, trying to leg it out, but Jones able to throw over to Byrne in time for out number one.
Jones has been the only infielder for UNCW that has been solid all day long. Playing defense.
Kevin Mahalan so far 1-3 on the day with a line out. As now we look ahead to the rest of the regular season schedule brought to you by Dart moving forward. Saturday, April 14th. Tomorrow, home against UNCW. And then Sunday, also home against UNCW. On Tuesday, Delaware will play in the Liberty Bell Classic championship game at Citizens Bank Park versus Lafayette. And then the next day they'll be home against St. Joe's. And then that weekend, April 20th through the 22nd, they will also host JMU. So a lot of games coming up for the Blue Hens in a short stretch.
Going to need a lot of arms from the pitching, on the pitching mound.
It's the next pitch. Be a swing and a miss. And if you're interested in that Wednesday game, April 18th against St. Joe's, we'll have that coverage on Hens All Access for you. It's Mahalan back in the box, 2-1 count. Royalty to deliver, and it hits Mahalan. So Mahalan will have first base.
Looks like they got the umpire, too. He's a little shaken up. Two for the price of one. Good job by royalty.
So now the Blue Heads will have a runner at first. As Jeffers will go talk to his pitcher, kind of calm him down, but also give the home plate umpire a little bit of time. Shake that one off. And now coming to the plate, Eric Bowerin, 1-for-3 on the day.
As soon as Mahalan gets to first base, he's always a threat to go.
Mahalan has not been thrown out this year, 12 stolen bases.
So why'd you say that? Now he's going to get thrown out.
Royalty comes set. Showed bunt, unable to get it down, though. Called strike. Coach Sherman not happy over there at third base with Bowerin right now.
Bowerin wasn't happy with himself either. Looked straight up. Knew he should have had that one down.
As now Weiss will come in a little bit. Play a little bit of bunt defense towards the grass-painted turf. As now they'll re-go through the signs for both Mahalan and Bowerin. Mahalan about two steps off the bag over there at first, being held on by Byrne. Royalty delivers home with a sidestep and a called strike on the outer half. Good. So now it'll be 0-2 count.
That was a good change by Royalty, too. He's been having a pretty high leg kick. Went in the stretch. Change it up to the sidestep. Throw off Mahalan's timing there at first.
So now Weiss can back up at third base with two strikes.
Went back to his high leg kick.
Pitch up high for a ball. 1-2 count now. Blue Hens trying to get something going with one away. McCone led off the inning with an out, and then Mahalan able to reach base thanks to a hit by a batter. And Mahalan's going. A swing and a miss. Mahalan is in there safely.
You're lucky.
So Bowerin will strike out, but Mahalan advances into scoring position with Baker coming to the plate.
Right fielder, number 12, Kyle Baker.
Baker today, 0-for-2. He's reached on an error, fielder's choice, and a walk. So even though he's 0-for-2, he's reached base all three times.
Baker also started that two-out rally with that walk that led to Patton's home run back in the fifth inning. See if he could get on base again. He could start another two-out rally. Ooh, that was the pitch.
Baker thought about it, but then held up.
There, yep.
So it'll be 0-1 to Baker, the right fielder for the Blue Hens, batting 319 on the year. Royalty comes set, sidestep, another called strike. So quickly, 0-2.
Gotta go down with a fight now. The runner in scoring position, you can't strike out here. At least put the ball in play. Make the defense make a play.
Especially, you want to give Nick Pan a chance after what he did in his last at bat against Royalty. The delivery. Baker puts it on the ground. A good stop by Jones. It'll be a long throw, and he's safe off the bag. So now runners at first and third for Nick Pan. And last time Nick Pan came up, he hit a bomb.
That would have been some play, though, by Jones. Full stretch into the hole, made the diving stop, and then got up quickly, fired that ball to first. He's played a good shortstop today. And that ball took off the turf, too.
Especially with a lot of hard hit balls, a lot of chopping balls against this turf. So now Royalty will have to face Penn. The home run that Royalty gave up to Penn, only the second home run he's given up all year. It's Penn's fourth on the gear, and now Penn's trying to extend the lead. The next home game is right around the corner tomorrow. The Hens continue the weekend series against UNCW. First pitch is at 1 p.m. And now we'll have a little meeting at the mound. As it looks like the day, we'll see if this is the end of the day for Royalty or not. It's a whole meeting.
The whole team's out of the dugout, so I would think they're taking him out.
Now hit the home plate umpire, and there's the signal. So we're going to have a pitching change here at Bob Hanna Stadium. We're going to step aside. Bottom seventh, Blue Hens leading this game 5-3.
We're home.
Let's go.
What kind of SUV is that?
It's a brand new Buick Enclave.
That really makes it easy to unload all those little maniacs.
Sure does.
Hey, honey, we should get one of those and have like a ton more kids.
Yeah, I love that. More kids.
Yeah.
Introducing the all-new Buick Enclave, tomorrow's SUV for today's family. Current lessees, switch to Buick and get this low-mileage lease on this 2018 Buick Enclave for around $369 per month.
Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium. Blue Hens trying to cause more damage, already up 5-3 as we look ahead at the CAA standings. Both these teams positioned in the middle of the pack. UNCW in third place in the conference, 4-2 over in the conference. Delaware right behind them, 3-3. So with a win today, Delaware could tie up and be 4-3, both of them. Ahead of them, Charleston 7-2 and Northeastern 5-1 in the conference. Both Northeastern and Charleston having great starts to their CAA season.
Yeah, this is a big series too for both UNCW and Delaware, as they are together in the middle of the pack for the CAA standings.
As now coming into pitch, Levi Gazelle for the Seahawks on the year. No earned runs. No decisions. This will be his third appearance. Only 2 1/3 innings thrown so far.
In those 2 1/3 innings, though, he does have 2 walks. So it looks we've only don't have much of a sample size, but control might be an issue for Gazelle out of the pen.
Also 2 strikeouts for Gazelle. And the first batter he's going to have to face is a powerful bat, Nick Patton.
That's definitely a tough task to ask for from Gazelle, coming in with runners on first and third, and Nick Patton coming to the plate, but luckily for him, he does have 2 outs to work with.
Especially Gazelle, the lefty, coming out of the pen, will have to face the righty in Patton. The first pitch will miss high, so Royalties' final line is not over yet, but he did pitch 6 2/3, and he is responsible for the runners on base. As Gazelle will come set, the 1-0 count. Patton pops that up to right field. He was unhappy with that. Lyles coming in, fighting the sun, will make the third out, and that's how the bottom of the seventh inning will end. We'll go to the top of the eighth inning. No runs, 1 hit, no errors. Blue Hens leading this game 5-3. As heading to the top of the eighth inning, Coleman Villa will be back out there for another inning of work, as we're going to step aside. Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium. We head to the top of the eighth inning. Hensley, this game 5-3. Coleman Villa back out there. Noah Lyles at the plate. Miss outside. So the line for Royalty, 6 2/3, 6 hits, 5 runs, 4 of which earned, 1 walk, 4 Ks, and he would be responsible for the loss. Next pitch is a called strike. It's a 1-1 count now.
Good outing, though, giving 6 2/3 for UNCW, especially with a 3-game weekend here in Newark.
Yeah, comes set, the delivery fouled off. Miller didn't know where that one went. He was looking up for it, but it went to the backstop.
Good job coming back here with 2 straight strikes after first pitch missed for a ball by Villa.
Because it looks like James Meeker is ready in the pen for the Hens whenever they might need him, the righty. Villa will come set for the 1-2 and gets a swing and a miss. Sends Lyles down on strikes. One away in the top of the eighth.
Good start to the eighth inning for Villa. Took some off of that one.
And now coming to the plate will be Ryan Jeffers. And it looks like we're going to have a pitching change here at Bob Hanna Stadium. So we'll step aside. Top eight, one away. Pitching change for the Blue Hens.
How do you want to live? As a decent person? Good husband. Is that it? Good? Of course not. King of the Hill? Better. Top of your game? Win. All powerful. Like a boss. Like a pro. We couldn't agree more. We are professional grade. Step up to GMC with over 11,500 total value on a specially equipped Sierra SLT crew cab model when you finance through GM Financial. We are professional grade. GM.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium. So we have a pitching change now coming onto the mound for the Blue Hens, James Meeker. Meeker on the year, 2.7 ERA, 4-0. So he has 12th appearance, 3 saves so far this year, 30 innings of work. 9 earned runs, 5 walks, 26 strikeouts.
Yeah, good outing right here needed from Meeker to finish this ball game and send Delaware into the win column to start this 3-game series.
And they might be asking him to do a 5-out save here. And if so, that would be huge for the Blue Hens, only having to use 2 arms out of the pen. The first game of a busy week coming ahead for them.
Yeah, it's a very busy week. Like you mentioned before, those 2 midweek games and then another series next weekend with James Madison.
Only 2 days off this whole week. Only Monday and Thursday off for the Hens.
Reintroducing catcher number 27.
And now coming to play, Ryan Jeffers. He'll try to make Meeker's life a little difficult up there at the plate.
He seemed to be good at that this year. Batting 342 with those 9 home runs.
So Villa was test to do get the 2 lefties righty in there and 2 switch hitters out, and now it's Meeker to get the righties out. 4 of them coming up to the plate in a row. Meeker taking a while to look at the signs. Will finally get it. Come set. And it will hit Jeffers. So now the Seahawks have a runner on with 1 away.
Not the start you wanted from Meeker coming out of the pen. First batter he faces and he hits him.
And especially with Mason Byrne coming up to the plate. Mason Byrne has not been hurting the Blue Hens yet today. Flew out to Mahal in his first at-bat. And then strikeouts. 1 looking in his next 2 at-bats. Meeker comes set, looks over it at first, but delivers home. It'll be a called strike on Byrne. Byrne, 1 of 3 hitters in this UNCW lineup without a hit today.
He's probably the one guy you expected to definitely have at least 1 hit today. leading the team with a 362 batting average.
Hit up the middle. Almost a good diving stop by Vacone. He's able to knock it down at least. And
jinxed him.
So Byrne will reach, and it will be runners at first and second with one away.
Now UNCW has a tying run on base now. Go ahead, runner stepping up to the plate. Meeker's going to have to buckle down and finish this inning strong and get to the bottom of the eighth.
Zach Canada will come to the plate. Try to change the score for the Seahawks. Delivery. Be fouled off. So an 0-1 count now to Canada. Canada today has grounded out to Hutchins, flew out to DeFebo, and has also been out when Hutchins went to Bowerin at second base. Not a lot of speed on the bases for UNCW. They're two power hitters, one at first and second, and Byrne and Jeffers. Both do have a stolen base on the year, though. Delivery misses outside. So it'll be a 1-1 count now. Meeker in a little bit of a jam coming into this game. Delivery gets a swing and a miss. A 1-2 count now to Canada.
Got to continue to keep the ball low, try to get the ground ball and induce the double play.
One out, two runners on, top eight. Beaker trying to get out of this jam. Love a double play ball right now. Instead, it'll go outside. It'll go back to the backstop. So both runners will advance. Now they have two runners in scoring position.
Not the pitch Delaware wanted from Meeker is not only letting the runners advance, but now there's no force, and now putting the ball in play will score a run.
And now the tying run, only 180 feet away from scoring. So they both advance on the wild pitch from Meeker. Be a 2-2 count to the Seahawks left fielder. And it'll be popped up out of play for foul ball, staying alive as Canada.
That's a good pitch by Meeker, getting the outside corner with that looking like slider.
UNCW yet to still have a hit with runners in scoring position 0 for 8. Blue Hens 2 for 8. Meeker will look to Miller for the signs. 2-2 delivery. Gets a swing and a miss.
Big pitch.
It was actually a foul tip. Went right into Miller's glove. He was very upset with it right after.
It's a great job by Miller, too, to squeeze that and hold on to it to get the strikeout. One out away from getting out of the jam.
Blake Deathridge will come to the plate. For the Seahawks, 2 for 3 so far today, 2 singles and a line out to left field. It's hit to shallow right field, and Bowerin makes another great catch on the outfield grass. UNCW unable to score any runs in the top of the eighth. We're going to go to the bottom of the eighth inning. Blue Hens leading this game 5-3.
Here's your chance to win big and adventure bigger on the Powerball Power Cruise on board Royal Caribbean's Majesty of the Seas. Play Powerball today and enter to be one of the lucky winners of an exclusive adventure of a lifetime. You'll enjoy a private concert featuring Kenny Loggins and even get a shot at $250,000 in cash prizes on board. The only way to get on board is to play Powerball and enter to win big.
Six Delaware Lottery players will win. Visit DELottery.com for details. Want to play?
Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium. We head to the bottom of the eighth inning. A pitching change as Levi Gazelle will hand the ball off to his younger brother, Luke Gazelle. The sophomore will come in to pitch for the Seahawks, down by two, as he'll try to just make sure that they don't give up any more runs in this inning. On the year, he has an 8.38 ERA in eight. This will be his ninth appearance, 9.2 innings off 18 runs, only nine of which earned, four walks, nine strikeouts.
Opponents have a pretty nice batting average against him, too, batting .333. He's given up two home runs as well.
Kind of the stat line you're hoping for to see come to the mound for the Blue Hens, as they'll have their 5-6-7 due up. Calvin Scott, DeFebo, and then Hutchins will round out the due up for the Hens.
Be nice to see if Delaware could add some insurance runs here in the bottom of the eighth to help the pitching in the top of the ninth.
And for the top of the ninth for UNCW, looking ahead, it will be 7-8-9. It will be Cole Weiss, Jackson Meadows, Noah Bridges will be the do-up for UNCW, as Calvin Scott tried to get his first hit on the day. He's grounded out twice and has reached on an error. First pitch is a called strike. Blue Hens haven't scored since the fifth inning of this game. Pitch to Scott, back to Ma, the plate. Now be a 1-1 count. First, the next pitch is a foul ball. Be 1-2 count now.
Scott wasn't happy with himself after that swing. He felt like he could have drove that ball. Instead, fouling it off behind home plate.
Gazelle left one hanging, and Calvin Scott was just early on that one.
Turned on the ball inside, too, and got a good piece of it. Just a little early.
So Gazelle will try to put Calvin Scott away. It's a 1-2 count. No one out. Bottom eight. Blue Hens leading this game 5-3. Thanks to a 3-run third inning and a 2-run five inning. A 2-run fifth inning. As it misses. It's a 2-2 count. Delivery. We'll miss once again, and now it's a full count to Calvin Scott.
Good job laying off the two. Last two pitches were both breaking balls. 3-2 count. See what Gazelle's going to do against Scott.
The delivery. Scott swings and misses through it. It's a strike, a strikeout for Gazelle, and one away now as DeFebo will come up to the plate.
Lucky alert, number 15.
DeFebo looking over at Coach Sherman.
Taking a long look down at third. Coach Sherman didn't take his hands off his hips because he's not giving any signs.
Infield in normal depth. First pitch, just missing a little high and outside. Ball one. The delivery, once again, missing outside. So it'll be 2-0 count to DeFebo. 2-0 count to DeFebo, trying to get something going, some insurance runs. Next pitch will also miss 3-0.
Three straight balls out of the zone. Looks look like to see if DeFebo's going to get a green light here.
The 3-0 delivery will be a strike.
Taking all the way.
Taking all the way. Wasn't even thinking about taking that bat off his shoulder. So that's a 3-1 count. You still have to have the mindset that it has to be a good pitch in order to drive it, swing at it.
3-1 pitch. 3-1. Still got to be his pitch. It might have been his pitch. That looked good.
It's a good-looking pitch, but he takes it. It's now a full count, 3-2 to DeFebo. The delivery. He'll put it into left field, past the outstretched glove of Jones, and DeFebo is on base for the first time today.
Good at bat by DeFebo. Although Gazelle just battle back after the 3-0 count, but he didn't let that fastball go by, and he drove it in between short and third.
Now Jordan Hutchins will come to the plate, the third baseman for the Blue Hens in his first at bat in the second inning, able to get a double down the right field line, and then ever since two ground outs in the fourth and the sixth inning. Batting 304 on the year. Gazelle takes a long look at DeFebo and then delivers. It's popped up in foul territory and will run out of real estate, out of play. So start off with an 0-1 count. Hutchins just trying to keep this inning going, one away, runner on first. They'll check over at the runner first. DeFebo is back in there safely. Now they'll check over once again. Almost caught him leaning. It was a close play over there.
Did get him leaning, just DeFebo barely getting his hand back in there before Byrne implied that tag.
So comes set. Delivers. It'll miss. It's a 1-1 count. DeFebo leads the team in being picked off twice this year. Almost got picked off for a third time earlier in this at-bat. DeFebo started to go and then holds up and then he'll throw back over. It was a pretty good throw, but able to get back in there safely.
Leading the team and getting picked off is probably not a stat you want to lead the team in.
Gazelle takes a long look over there first. DeFebo is definitely in his head. The delivery be fouled off, evens up the count at 2-2. These could be crucial runs for the Blue Hens late in this game. With a 2-run lead, always want to extend that lead if you can. And they'll try to get DeFebo. It hits the umpire. And I think UNC Wilmington should give an umpire a little gift. Otherwise, DeFebo would have been at second base.
That ball was caught at first base. That probably would have been another close play on DeFebo sliding back in there.
The 2-2 delivery to Hutchins. As DeFebo goes, swing and a miss, and DeFebo at second base. They're going to say he's out, so a strike him out, throw him out. And that's how the bottom of the eighth inning will end. No runs on one hit, no errors. Blue Hens will try to close out this game in the top of the ninth, leading this game 5-3.
Calling all creators.
Those with the need
to make something new.
Who are obsessed with progress.
Creativity is everything in today's game.
It's about making a statement.
I think what we're all trying to do is leave a mark so the game will never be the same.
The game will never
be the same.
We're all creators.
Related by a mindset.
That's our job, to continue to try to enlighten while we inspire.
I've been taking the example of it, but now I have to create for myself.
It's not about borders,
gender,
or race.
I ain't trying to stay in my lane. I'm trying to strike while the iron hot.
It's all intertwined. Fashion inspires music.
Music, art, design, and sport together.
Come on, Hopkins. You know you listening to Pusha T before you hit the field. And Aaron Rodgers, maybe you should.
Join us.
Join us.
Pull up a chair.
Let's change sport.
Let's change lives.
Let's create.
Let's create.
Welcome back to Bob Hanna Stadium as we head to the top of the ninth inning. Meeker back out there to try to close things out and a two-run Blue Hens lead. And he'll have to face 7, 8, 9. It'll be Weiss, Meadows, and Bridges due up.
It'd be nice to see if Meeker could sit him down 1, 2, 3 and give all the Delaware faithful an easy ninth inning and no heart attacks here.
The righty will have to face two lefties in the do-up. Weiss and Bridges, both lefties, and Weiss will be up to the plate now. First pitch will miss for a ball. As Weiss today, 1-for-3, a double to left center, and then lined out to Vacone and grounded out to Bowron. And that pitch is a swing and a miss.
He was ahead of that one.
Meeker. Will deliver. And a called strike. 1-2 count now.
So going right after the hitter now.
Meeker trying to get this 1-2-3. Top of the ninth, unlike the eighth inning when he came in, it will be hit to Bowron at second base. Meeker covering and will get the out.
Good play by Meeker getting over there. Saw Patton was maybe went a little bit too far over to try to get that ground ball that was heading to Bowron, but good play by Meeker getting over there.
And now pinch hitting number 38, Zach Bridges. He'll come in to pinch hit. Meeker's going to try to get him out, and then due up after him will be Bridges, the lefty. First pitch be a called strike to Zach Bridges. On deck is Noah Bridges.
Is there any relation there, Michael?
The delivery will be fouled off behind the screen, 0-2 count. And now it seems like Meeker has settled down. I would assume that both of them are brothers, considering they went to the same high school and are from the same hometown.
They could be cousins. Never think of that.
So Zach Bridges try to cause some harm for Meeker. Come set the delivery and good just pitch. Fouled it off. Just barely got a piece of that.
Trying
ball.
Going upstairs now with that fastball. Let's see if he's going to try to do that again. It's a good pitch, but Bridges is on it.
So it'll be an 0-2 count to Zach Bridges. Meeker trying to get him out, trying for a 1-2-3 inning. It'll be hit down the right field line in foul territory and in the UNCW bullpen. So it'll remain 0-2. A good pinch hit so far at bat for Zach Bridges.
Yeah, that got a good piece of that one. That's not a good 0-2 pitch right there by Meeker. Want to get him to try to chase something here now.
So Meeker will come set for another 0-2 pitch. And that one's fouled off once again. Meeker trying to figure out what he can do to get him out. DeFebo in left field playing more left center right at the 352 sign and the new Blue Hen logo in left field. The delivery. He'll be hit to Bowerin at second base. The throw to Penn. And there's two outs. Blue Hen's one out away from a win.
Meeker finally found the pitch that was going to get Bridges out. And back-to-back ground balls to Bowerin to start the ninth inning.
Center fielder, number 22, Noah Bridges.
And now Noah Bridges will come to the plate. It's Meeker trying to get this final out in the top of the ninth inning. And it'll be hit right to Penn. He caught it on the line. And does that not explain today a lot of hard hit balls, but the Blue Hens right in the way of all those hard hit balls?
Yep. Defense came up to play after the rough first couple innings, but defense definitely helped out the pitchers here today.
So the Blue Hens win game one of the series 5-3 against the Seahawks. Meeker comes in, gets the final five outs. Hinton gets the win, and then the loss will go to royalty for the Seahawks. They'll continue the series tomorrow and Sunday. We'll have coverage of softballs tomorrow, doubleheader starting at noon. Before Danny Letty, for producer Brad Wallach, for replay operator Nate Edwards, and camera operator Justin Liggett, this is Michael Baumel saying thank you for watching Hens All Access. Have a great rest of your Friday, and have a great rest of your weekend.